وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، وإن شرح في الكتاب نواقض الإسلام written by شيخ الإسلام محمد بن عبد الوهاب رحمه الله تعالى. The Shaykh rahimahullah, he says, the seventh naqid, the seventh nullifier, السحر ومنه الصرف والعطف فمن فعله أو رضي به كفر، والدليل قوله تعالى وما يعلمان من أحد حتى يقولا إنما نحن فتنة فلا تكفر. The author rahimahullah, he goes into the issue of as-sihr, and the way inshallah ta'ala we plan to go through it is in couple of masail, couple of points that inshallah ta'ala we will mention. The masail that we're going to mention are going to be 6 masail inshallah ta'ala. 6 points inshallah ta'ala is what we're going to mention regarding this whole issue بإذن الله الكريم. The first one is, what does sihr mean في اللغة, in the language? المسألة الأولى, the first point, what does magic mean? معنى السحر في اللغة, what does magic mean in the language? السحر لغة, سحر linguistically means عبارة عن كل شيء خفي سببه. سحر in its language is everything that is reason is hidden. لذلك the Arabs, they use the thing that's hidden, excessively hidden. They refer to it as sihr. As it's in the statement of Muslim ibn Walid al-Ansari, جعلت العلامات المودة بيننا مصائد لحظهن أخفى من السحر. So السحر is what? It means to be hidden. So what he says, أخفى من السحر, more hidden than سحر. ولذلك that's why we use the word سحور. What do we use the word? سحور. Why do we call it the word سحور? لأنه يكون في آخر الليل. Because it's at the last portion of the night. It's the last. Barakallah. I had to ask for it, yeah. لأنه يكون في آخر الليل. Because it's the last part of the night. And it's hidden. And the person is eating. Like at that time, the people wouldn't switch on their lights and eat. Okay, so it was in a dark room where they would eat. If you want to go back to Lisan al-Arab, 6th volume, page 189, you can go to Al-Musbah al-Munir, page 102. You could go to Mu'jam Maqayis al-Lugha, 506, Tab'at Dar al-Fikr. You can go to Al-Mu'jam al-Wasit. You could go to Tafsir al-Qurtubi, Adwa' al-Bayan, Kitab al-Ayn, by Khalil, Ahmed ibn Khalil al-Farahidi. Tafsir al-Kathir, with the tahqiq of Sheikh Muqbil rahimahullah. Now we go to al-mas'alatu al-thaniyah, the second mas'ala, which is ma'ana al-sihru fi al-istilah. What does magic actually mean technically? What does it technically mean? The term and the usage of the ulama, what sihr means, is excessive. They've disputed a lot. Why did they dispute a lot? وَذَلِكَ لِكَثْرَةِ الْأَنْوَاعِ الْمُخْتَلَفَةِ. Because the types of magic are different. So the definition is different. The different types of categories that fall under magic are different due to that it made the definition technically different. So no one has actually come out and given a ta'rif which is jami' mani', a comprehensive definition. ولذلك الأمين الشنقيطي says in his أضواء البيان اعلم أن السحر في الاصطلاح لا يمكن حده بحد جامع مانع. Says that. He says اعلم know that magic. He says in his كتاب أضواء البيان, the first volume, page 391. He says that know that magic technically cannot be defined a definition which is comprehensive. Why? لكثرة الأنواع المختلفة. The different types. Due to the different types. Due to what? Due to the different types that fall under it. So this is the reason. But inshallah ta'ala, I'm just going to mention two ta'rifs. Ta'rifayni lil'ulama'i aktafi bihima inshallah. I'm going to suffice myself with two definitions of two noble imams. First one is al-imamu shafi'iyu rahimahullah. Al-imamu shafi'iyu, he said in his kitab al-um, taba'at dar al-fikr, he says that sihr is a general term لِمَعَانٍ مُخْتَلِفَ for different meanings. That's what he said. It's a general term for different meanings. That's what Shafi'i said. The second one is Ibn Qudama. Ibn Qudama. He said this, rahimahullah, in his kitab Al-Kafi. The fourth volume, page 164. He said that it is knots and blowing that affects the body and the heart. The person becomes ill. It can kill the person as well. It can divide between two loved ones. This is what he defined it as. If you want more into seeing other definitions as well, and you want is the ada, you want to increase in more, then I think you should go to the 12th volume, page 299, the Kitab Al-Mughni Ibn Qudama rahimahullah. If you go to Al-Mughni, the 12th volume, page 299, you get more understanding and more definitions from Ibn Qudama rahimahullah there. You could also go to the Tafsir Ahkam Al-Quran, the Ahkam Al-Quran that is written by Ibn Al-Arabi rahimahullah. Ibn al-Arabi, the great Maliki scholar. First volume, page 31. You can also even go to the Muqaddimah ibn Khaldun. And recently, Taba'a Jadida, Muhaqqaqa, Munaqqaha came out from the Muqaddimah ibn Khaldun. Rather, they actually published the whole tariq of Ibn Khaldun. All of it. Before it was only the Muqaddimah. They actually published all of it. So it's a new publication that came out. Try to buy it. Ala kulli hal, we're now going to move on to the mas'ala to thalitha, the third mas'ala, insha'Allah ta'ala, which is aqsamu sihri. How many types of magic are there? How many types of magic are there? The scholars of Ahlul Ilm, they mentioned in their books that the magic is categorized into many different categories, many. Like in all of those categories they mentioned can be brought back to two, can be summarized into two. كلها ترجع إلى قسمين. All of it go back to two categories. The first of them is, the first one of them, which is that which is done, okay, through knots. And it's done through blowing and recitation and talisman. The person is given a, you know what a talisman is, right? Ta'weez. Ta'weez can be ropes as well, stuff like that, but this is more. But yeah, through it, magic is used. The person is gaining aid and support from the shayateen in what they want. So they can harm the person which they're afflicting the magic with. This one, the evidence for this category, the first category, is the statement of Allah, وَاتَّبَعُوا مَا تَتْلُوا الشَّيَاطِينُ عَلَى مُلْكِ سُلَيْمَانَ وَمَا كَفَرَ سُلَيْمَانَ ولكن الشياطين كفروا يعلمون الناس السحر. سورة البقرة آية 102. The second one is it is the magic that's done through adwiya medication. It affects the physical side of the person who the magic is being done to. It affects his brain. It even affects his wants and his wills and his iradat. It also weakens him bit by bit until it destroys him. It also can affect his brain, as I said, where it can take the person to become crazy. It also destroys the person's perception. The person starts to see things as it really is. But this one, there's no usage of shayateen. Those are the two types. I took it from Shaykh Ibn al-Uthaymeen rahimahullah. He mentions that in his fatawa, the second volume, page 178. Shaykh Ibn al-Uthaymeen, like he took it from Shafi'i, who mentions in his kitab al-Umm, first volume 293. Also al-Qirafi rahimahullah, in his al-Qirafi rahimahullah, he mentions in his kitab al-Furuq, fourth volume, page 147 to 150. Ibn Qudama mentions it in his kitab Al-Mughni, ninth volume, page 34. Adwa'ul Bayan, Muhammad Al-Amin Al-Shanqiti mentions fourth volume, page 444 to page 455. Hafiz Ibn Hajar mentions it in his Fathul Bari, 10th volume, page 222. Ibn Kathir mentions it in his Tafsir, first volume, page 129. So these are where all of those information you can find. There's a strong benefit and a very strong tanbih, alert, that was brought by none other than Sahib al-Taysir al-Aziz al-Hamid, Sulaiman ibn Abdullah ibn Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahab, the grandson of Muhammad Abdul Wahab, and the first one who explained Kitab al-Tawheed. He said, وَأَمَّا السِّحْرُ الْأَدْوِيَةِ, the second type of magic that I mentioned, and like it, فَلَيْسَ بِسِحْرٍ, this is not really magic. وَإِنَّمَا سُمِّيَ سِحْرًا, it was only called magic, فَعَلَى سَبِيلِ الْمَجَازِ, it was only said metaphorically, كَتَسْمِيَةِ الْقَوْلِ الْبَلِيغِ, just like when a person is very eloquent, okay, it's called what? Sihr. This person's got sihr, like, the eloquent speech is called sihr. If you want more into this, you can go to the Muqaddimah ibn Khaldun, page 311, Ma'arij al-Qabul, written by Hafiz al-Hakamiyu, second volume, page 259, and also Hafiz ibn Hajar al-Fath al-Bari, the 10th volume, page 225, Al-Taba' al-Salafiyya. Fourth point that we're going to now move on to is هَلْ لِلْسِحْرِ حَقِيقَةً أَمْ هُوَ خَيَالٌ فَقَطْ. Is magic literal? Is it real? Or is it just delusion? Is it illusionary? Or is magic something that really exists? This mas'ala is a khilaf not between Ahlul Sunnah. It's not a khilaf between Ahlul Sunnah فيما بينهم, amongst themselves. The khilaf of whether magic is real or if it's illusionary is a khilaf between Ahlul Sunnah and the deviated group, the Mu'tazila, وَمَنْ وَافَقَهُمْ, and those who agreed with them. Like Ibn Hazm al-Zahiri, who agreed with them. And also Abu Ishaq al-Istrabidi, who agreed with them. And also the great Imam who agreed with them, Abu Hanifa al-Nu'man ibn Thabit, rahimahullah, who also believed that magic is not literal. He believed it is what? Magic is khayal, it's just illusionary. There's no real magic. But Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah, they took the opinion that the magic is two types. Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah, they took the opinion that magic is what? Two types. مَا لَهُ حَقِيقَةً, magic that has, it's real, it's true, okay? And it has clear effects on the person. And it harms the person who the magic is being done to, with the permission of who? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It can also affect the person's aql, the person's thinking. It can affect the person's what? It can also affect the person's irada, the person's will and wishes and wants. It can affect it. It can divide a person and take him away from his loved one, his spouse, his wife. This doesn't require much, because the waqi' shows it as well. The Qur'an and the Sunnah show it, and also the waqi', the reality that we're in, actually shows it as well. The second type is مَا كَانَ تَخْيِيلًا أَمَا تَخَيُّلًا. It's something that is, it is not literal, it's illusionary. This is the second type. And the evidence for this one is the one Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala mentioned about the magicians of Fir'aun. What did Allah say about them? سَحَرُوا أَعْيُنَ النَّاسِ وَاسْتَرْهَبُوهُمْ وَجَاءُوا بِالسِّحْرٍ عَظِيمٍ. Look what Allah said about them. سَحَرُوا أَعْيُنَ النَّاسِ. They brought illusion to the eyes of the people. Also Allah says in Surah Al-Taha, يُخَيَّلُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ سِحْرِهِمْ أَنَّهَا تَسْعَى. They made it seem to their eyes that their ropes that they threw, it was moving. That's what they thought. So all of this, those two ayat, it indicates that there's two types. Some magic which is real, does happen. And a magic which is illusionary, it's not real. So what's the evidence that there is, what's the evidence for the first type? I'm going to mention, inshallah ta'ala, six different points. Number one is that Allah said in the Quran, وَمِن شَرِّ النَّفَّاثَاتِ فِي الْعُقَدِ. وَمِن شَرِّ, from the evil is النَّفَّاثَاتِ, the one who blows in the عُقَد, the knots. So Allah is talking about in this ayah the magicians who are blowing into the knots which they made. If the sihr had no reality to it, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala would not have commanded us to seek refuge in Him from it, because something that doesn't literally exist and has no reality, لا يتعوذ منه. Should we seek refuge from it? Something that doesn't have, you don't seek refuge in it from it. Number two, which is يعلمون الناس السحرة. They teach the people what? They teach the people? They teach the people magic, as Allah mentioned in Surah Al-Baqarah. So Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He tells us here, أن السحرة يعلم. Magic is taught. وَمَا لَا حَقِيقَةَ لَهُ, that which has no reality to it, and it doesn't exist. فَلَا يُعَلَّمْ, how can it be taught? It doesn't exist. So Allah is telling us this. Point number three. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He tells us, فَيَتَعَلَّمُونَ مِنْهُمَا مَا يُفَرِّقُ بِهِ بَيْنَ الْمَرْءِ وَزَوْجِهِ. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala affirmed in this ayah that the sihr has a reality to it, which is that it can be a cause to divide between a man and his wife, and something that has no reality to it. It can't have an effect. It can't have an effect. Not to mention the fact that Allah used فَيَتَعَلَمُونَ مِنْهُمَا مَا يُفَرِّقُونَ بِهِ. And the word here, مَا, is موصولة. And the موصولة here تدل على أنه شيء له حقيقة. It shows that it's something that has a reality to it. Because the مَا is something that's there, that can be seen. Number four, that which has been narrated by Bukhari and Muslim, and on the authority of our mother Aisha, that she said, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was, magic was placed on him from a man from the people of Zurayq, and his name was Labid ibn al-A'sam. He is the one who placed magic on the Prophet alayhi salatu wasallam, until the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would what? He would see things, or he would think he did something which he didn't really do, alayhi salatu wasalam. So it shows you that the magic has a real effect. There it is, it's happening to the Prophet, and it's real, it's happening. And something that doesn't, is not real, cannot have an effect on you. Number five, when the two angels came to the Prophet, when the magic was done on him, when the two angels came to the Prophet, one said to the other, وَمَا وَجَعُ الرَّجُلُ, what's the man's illness? They were talking to each other, the two angels were talking to each other. So they said to each other, what's this man's illness? Nabilahi Muhammad. One said, Matbubun. Matbubun means a what? Mariidun. He's sick from magic. So if magic wasn't something that is real, then it wouldn't have affected the Prophet's body like this, because he's sick. He's sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was lying down. Number six is that the hadith of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anhuma, she said, قَالَ, that she said, قَدْ عَفَانِ اللَّهُ, Allah cured me, the Prophet said. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala cured me. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He cures a person who is sick, a person who had an illness on them. Because shafa means زَوَالُ المرض. It means رَفْعُ الْعِلَّةِ وَزَوَالُ المرض. That the illness and the problem that was with you is being uplifted from you. So this shows and indicates, فَدَلَّ عَلَى أَنَّ لَهُ حَقًّا, that magic has a truth to it, and it has a haqiqah and a reality to it. And there are many other evidences we could bring. These 6 points are enough. As for the second type of magic, which is magic known as the takhil or tamwih, And magic which is التخيل. The magic which is known as سحر, which is تخيل. In which the person starts to see things in a way where it's not illusionary, is the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what he said about the magicians of Fir'aun. The magicians of Fir'aun, their magic wasn't the first time, it was the second time. As we're going to bring the kalam of Muhammad al-Amin al-Shanqiyati rahimahullah. The magicians of Fir'aun, their magic was illusionary, it wasn't haqiqah. I'm going to bring the kalam of Muhammad al-Amin al-Shanqiyati rahimahullah in Adwa'u al-Bayan. Which is that, qala alqu, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Musa said to them, throw. فَلَمَّا أَلْقَوْ سَحَرُ أَعْيُنَ النَّاسِ. When they threw, Allah tells us here that they placed on the people's eyes illusion. The people started to see things differently. That's the first evidence. Surah Al-A'raf, Ayah 116. In Surah Al-Taha, Ayah 66, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, قَالَ بَلْ أَلْقُوا فَإِذَا حِبَالُهُمْ وَعِصِيُّهُمْ يُخَيَّلُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ سِحْرِهِمْ أَنَّهَا تَسْعَى. The ropes that they threw on the floor, it started to move, and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala clearly says, يُخَيَّلُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ سِحْرِهِمْ. Clearly use the word يُخَيَّلُ. يُخَيَّلُ means what? It was illusionary, it wasn't a reality. So this is the case. The third evidence, brothers, is I brought evidence for both of the two types. I brought evidence for there's a magic is haqiqah. Ahlul Sunnah believe that. Except the Mu'tazila and some of the Aima Salaf, like Al-Imam Abu Hanifa, who agreed with them, the other ulama Ahlul Sunnah believe that there's no such a thing as what? So they believe there is such a thing as a magic which is haqiqah. Also Abu Ibn Hazm al-Dahir, who agreed with them, and others as well. There's an ijma' on this issue. The Salaf of Hadi al-Ummah, they believe magic was literal. The three early generations, until they came the Mu'tazila, the magic was believed to be literal, haqiqah. This ishkal and this khilaf only came from the Mu'tazila. I'm going to bring you the ijma' of the ulama. And Imam al-Qarafi, he brings the ijma' in his kitab al-Furuq. He says that, كان السحر وخبره معلوما للصحابة رضوان الله عليهم أجمعين. That magic and the news pertaining to, the information pertaining to it, to the companions, it was well known. The Sahabas knew about it. They knew magic, they agreed there was literal magic that's real. وَكَانُوا مُجْمِعِينَ عَلَيْهِ قَبْلَ ظُهُورِ الْقَدَرِيَّةِ. Until the Qadariyah came, okay, the Mu'tazila and deviated groups like that, until they came, this matter was not talked about, it wasn't discussed, no one was arguing about it. It was from them, musallamat, it was from the agreed things, surrendered to. Al-Wazir ibn Hubayra, in his kitab al-Ifsah, he says, he mentions, أجمعوا, they unanimously agreed upon, على أن السحر له حقيقة. That sihr has a reality to it. Look what he said after that, إلا أبا حنيفة, except أبا حنيفة. قال لا حقيقة لو عنده. Look, the ijma' still is there, even though Abu Hanifa went against it. Why? Because the ijma' was mun'aqid قبل وجود Abu Hanifa. Before Abu Hanifa came, the ijma' was there. Abu Hanifa went against the ijma'. Does that make sense? When can an ijma', when is kharqul ijma' possible? When can an ijma' be broken? When the time of the ijma' is taking place, if the person opposes it. Does that make sense? Then we can say that this is mas'ala mukhtalafu fih. Like if the sahabas agreed, and then the tabi'een agreed, and then Abu Hanifa comes and then he disagrees on this issue, then his khilaf la itibara lahu. There's no consideration for it. Are we all together? Because the ijma' is what? It's mun'aqid. And the qa'ida is that la yamutu al-qawla bi mawti qa'ili, sah? If a statement is said by somebody, by the sahabas or something, are we going to dismiss their ijma' and say that because they died, the ijma' goes as well? No. Their khilaf, their ijma', all of it is going to be taken into consideration. على كل حال, this mas'ala is ijma'. Nowadays you find people trying to bring this issue out and say, look at this, this is a khilafi issue and this whatnot. Now I'm going to bring نقولات العلماء, some statements of the scholars who said that the magic is categorized into two. قسم له حقيقة, a type that is real, and آخر, which is that it is illusionary. The first one is الشيخ سليمان, the sharih of the kitab al-tawheed, kitab al-tawheed, sahib al-kitab, Taysir al-Aziz al-Hamid. He was the first one to explain Kitab al-Tawheed. He didn't finish it, by the way. He didn't finish the explanation of it. But it got finished by Abdul Rahman ibn Hassan ibn Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahab, who is the cousin of Sulaiman. He wrote a one called Fath al-Majid fi Sharh Kitab al-Tawheed. He finished it. That's why that one became the biggest scholars. They done the most towards that one, Fath al-Majid, because it's complete and it's finished. But it's a summary. If Sulaiman was to finish his one, he would have been more longer, because he was going into great details, whereas Abdul Rahman was shorter and smaller. Ala kulli hal, al-Shaykh Sulaiman, he says in his Taysir Aziz al-Hamid, page 383, he says, وَقَدْ زَعَمَ قَوْمٌ مِنَ الْمُعْتَزِلَةِ, a group of the Mu'tazila claim, and other than them, that the sihr is illusionary. لا حقيقة له, that it has no reality. وهذا ليس بصحيح, that is not correct. على إطلاقه, unrestrictedly. بل منه ما هو تخيل, because there is some magic which is تخيل. ومنه ما هو حقيقة, and there's also that which is real. That's the كلام الشيخ سليمان. القرافي, he says in his كتاب الفروق, he says السحر له حقيقة. Magic has real reality to it. There's real magic, which the person who the magic is being done to can die from it. Or he can even change his nature and the way he is and his norms, even if he's not come into contact with. وَقَالَ بِهِ الشَّافِعِيُّ, he said. Al-Imam al-Shafi'iyyu said this. Ibn Hanbal said this. The Qadariyya said لا حقيقة للسحر. The Qadariyya, on the other hand, they said there's no reality to the sihr, he says. And look what he said after. وَلَلَا الْكِتَابُ وَالسُّنَّةُ وَالْإِجْمَعَةُ, and with us is the Kitab and the Sunnah and the Ijma'ah to prove that there is magic which is haqiqa and magic which is takhayyul. And then he starts to give the evidences for them. Al-Maziri, he says, madhhab ahli sunnah. This is a naqal from Al-Imam Al-Shawkani in his Nail Al-Awtar. He says that Al-Maziri said, madhhab ahli sunnah, the madhhab of ahli sunnah wal jama'ah, wa jumhur ulama'i ummah, and the overwhelming majority of the scholars of this ummah, is ithbatu sihri to affirm magic. Wa anna lahu haqiqa, and that it has a reality, ka haqiqati ghayrihi min al-ashya, that it has a reality like other things have reality. Khilafan liman ankara dhalik, in opposition to those who've rejected the existence of a real type of magic. And then he mentions their kalam. Same with Adwa'u al-Bayan, Muhammad al-Amin al-Shanqitiyu. He says, when it came to the ayah, يُخَيَّلُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ سِحْرِهِمْ أَنَّهَا تَسْعَى, he said, يَدُلُّ عَلَى أَنَّ السِّحْرَى, he said that this shows that magic, الَّذِي جَاءَ بِهِ سَحَرَةُ فِرْعَوْنِ, this ayah shows, يُخَيَّلُ إِلَيْهِ مِنْ سِحْرِهِمْ أَنَّهَا تَسْعَى, Surah Taha, ayah 66. He said, this ayah shows, okay, that the magic that Fir'aun, the magicians of Fir'aun came with, was the type which is known as the illusionary magic. It was all an illusion. لا حقيقة له في نفس الأمر. This magic in its essence, it had no reality to it. وهذا دلت عليه آية طه. Surah طه indicated this. And Surah أعراف. And then look what he says after that. After he brings those two ayat, فألقوا, they threw their ropes at what they had. And then he says, سحروا أعين الناس, Surah أعراف آية 16. And then he brings Surah طه آية 66. And then he says, يَدُلُّ عَلَىٰ أَنَّهُمْ خَيَّلُوا لِأَعْيُنِ النَّاظِرِينَ أَمْرًا لَا حَقِيقَةَ لَهُمْ, that they place illusion to the eyes of the people, there was no reality to their magic. وَبِهَاتَيْنِ الْآيَتَيْنِ, look what he says after that. He said, these two ayat, which two ayat is he referring to? Ayat Surah Araf, ayat Surah Taha, those are the two ayat, احْتَجَّ الْمُعْتَزِلَ, that the Mu'tazila use as a proof. وَمَنْ قَالَ بِقَوْلِهِمْ, and those who said their statement, عَلَىٰ أَنَّ السِّحْرَ, that sihr is only illusion, لا حقيقة له, and it has no reality to it. والتحقيق الذي عليه جماهير العلماء من المسلمين, but the statement that the ulama are upon, which is the correct statement, is أن السحر منه ما هو أمر له حقيقة لا مطلق التخيل له, that magic, this is the correct, that there is from the magic that which is real, that doesn't have unrestricted تخيل, ومنه ما هو تخيل. And there is also a second type, which is magic, which is تخيل, illusionary. The person starts to see things. So this is تحقيق that the ulama of the Muslimin are upon. Qurtubi also mentions the same. Qurtubi rahimahullah, he mentions the same. And Qurtubi, his kalam is very long, so I'm just going to give you the khulasa what he says. He mentions that the Abatul Mu'tazila, the overwhelming majority of the Mu'tazila and those who agreed with them, and some of the followers of Ashabu Shafi'iyah, the followers of Madhab Shafi'iyah, they said that sihr, it has no reality to it. Okay? And Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah said, no, the magic is in two categories. Category which is haqiqah, and that which is takhayyul. And look what he said after that. He said the Mu'tazila, the problem that came to them, the reason why it came to them is because they took ba'd al-nusus wa taraku ba'd. They took some of the text and they didn't take the rest. So they only took the ayat, ayah Surah Al-Araf and ayah what? Surah Al-Taha. Ayah 116 is Surah Al-Araf. And ayah 66 is Surah Al-Taha. They took those two and they dismissed the ayah Surah Al-Baqarah. Where Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, ayah 102, where Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala says, وَاتَّبَعُوا مَا تَتْلُوا الشَّيَاطِينُ عَلَى مُلْكِ سُلَيْمَانَ وَمَا كَفَرَ سُلَيْمَانَ وَلَكِنَّ الشَّيَاطِينَ كَفَرُوا يُعَلِّمُونَ النَّاسَ السِّحْرَ. They left those ayat which were clear. And many other ayats we're going to show, inshaAllah Ta'ala. They didn't take those ayat. And Surah وَمِنْ شَرِّ النَّفَّاثَاتِ فِي الْعُقَدِ. They didn't take those. وَلِذَلِكَ عَلَامَةُ أَهْلِ الْبِدَعِ. The sign that you can recognize a person from the innovators is أَخْذِ بَعْضِ النُّصُوصِ, taking some of the texts and dismissing the rest. And basing a general ruling on some of the evidences. Ahl al-Sunnah are known for what? يَذْكُرُونَ مَا لَهُمْ وَمَا عَلَيْهِمْ. They bring all the nusus together. They bring everything that they have to the table. They look at everything, then they deduct a ruling from it. The reason why Ahlul Bid'ah fall into that is يَعْتَقِدُونَ ثُمَّ يَسْتَدِلُّونَ فَيَضِلُّونَ. They believed in something before. So when they believed in something, they start looking at the Qur'an. Whatever agrees with them, they take. And what doesn't agree with them, they dismiss it. So this is what happened in this regard. Also Ibn al-Qayyim in his kitab Bada'i al-Fawa'id, the second volume, page 227, he also talks about this issue in more details. Rahimahullah ta'ala. So Ahlul Sunnah, there's no dispute in regards to this issue. Mas'alatul Khamisa, the fifth mas'ala that we're going to go into inshaAllah ta'ala is هَلْ يَسْتَطِيعُ السَّاحِرُ. Can the magician, okay? We said that magic is real, okay? And we also said there is illusion magic. When we said that the magic is haqiqah, we meant it really can affect a person. It can really cause a person harm. It can put a person to bed. It can kill a person. It can make a person lose their mind and become majnoon. It can make a person do things they don't want to do. It can do that to a person. Here the question is, are we all together? But can the magician turn something really in its essence? Make this cup, not illusion, really turn it into better than a horse, a cow, when it's not illusion. Can he do that? And is that something possible? Can he turn a human being into a monkey? Or a monkey into a human being? When it's not illusion, haqiqatan, literally. Remember when we were talking about the haqiqah, what we were talking about? That it literally can affect a person, sah? But can it change something from its essence without it being a miracle from Allah? We're all together. Because miracle is not a magic, is it? No, it's not. This is what, can magic change something from its real essence and turn it to be what? And can it turn it to something else? We'll leave this for next lesson, inshaAllah ta'ala. Anything which I have said which is wrong or incorrect is from me, shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.